Hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss an important concept, that is the functions of Golgi complex. So in the functions of Golgi complex, actually, the Golgi complex main important function is the packaging and secretion. Packaging and secretion. Here, you can see these are the organelles, they packing the material into the vacuoles and finally they secrete into the outside. So let us see, for example, the cell that contains nucleus that produces the endoplasmic reticulum. This endoplasmic reticulum is two types, smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum that produces the proteins or synthesize the proteins. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum that synthesizes the lipids. Is it right? We know very well about this. Now, these lipids and proteins which are present in the endoplasmic reticulum in the form of vesicles. In the form of vesicles. These vesicles are released by the endoplasmic reticulum into the cytoplasm. Now, the perinuclear membrane that contained Golgi complex is taken up these vesicles. Taken up these vesicles, we know very well, this is all about Golgi complex. Taken up these vesicles into the these formative structures and which converts some modifications into the lipids and proteins. There are also some polysaccharides. Polysaccharides. So, the modification which can done for the lipids and proteins which are released by the endoplasmic reticulum, that endoplasmic reticulum released vacuoles are absorbed by the Golgi complex. Finally, the Golgi complex made some changes into the protein, lipids and carbohydrates that releases the outside. That releases outside or that releases to the specialized areas, that is the targeted areas like plasma membrane or any secretions to the outside. So, let us see the packaging of packaging material. It may be polysaccharide, it may be lipids and it may be proteins. Is it right? For example, if you take the polysaccharides, may secrete by the Golgi complex, especially in the goblet cells. The goblet cells that contains the Golgi complex, that Golgi complex secretes the polysaccharides by the goblet cells. Now, proteins, protein secretion. Proteins are the very essential for the any function of cell. So, proteins are secreted by the Golgi complex that are very essential for the liver and pancreas. Especially SNR cells of pancreas that produces the many enzymes. Here enzymes are nothing but proteins. So such production and secretion is done by the SNR cells of pancreas because of that contains the huge number of Golgi complex. I already mentioned wherever the cells that contains the secretory functions, such cells that contains huge amount of the Golgi complex. Is it right? Now this is all about. There is a collagen is a protein. This collagen also secreted by the connective tissue. This connective tissue secreting this collagen because of the some important organelles, that is the Golgi complex. Okay, is it clear? This is all about the packaging and secretions. Packaging and secretions. The next point is post-translation modification. Very, very important function of Golgi complex. Very, very important function of Golgi complex is the post-translation modification. Then what is the translation? We know very well the DNA that converted into the mRNA through the process of transcription, the mRNA that binds to the ribosomes and produces a protein or polypeptide. This polypeptide we called as a protein. Now, this protein is came from the single-stranded mRNA by the translation. Now, you can see post-translation modification. After translation, post means after. After translation, some modification can done for the proteins. That modification is done by the complex structure called as a Golgi complex. What is that translation modification? Glycosylation. Glycosylation is a process where this Golgi complex which add oligosaccharides onto the proteins and also lipids. We know very well the endoplasmic reticulum that contains the ribosomes. We already discussed that ribosome that producing the proteins. Already discussed that proteins are enter into the endoplasmic reticulum from the ribosomes. So, from where it enter into the Golgi complex? The Golgi complex actually what it doing? It changes some on the proteins. For example, proteins that is added by the oligosaccharides, which is called as a glycoproteins. Whereas, if the lipids that is secreted by the smooth endoplasmic reticulum, that lipids can be added by the oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharides be called as a glycolipids. Is it right? The glycolipids and glycoproteins is formed by the Golgi complex. Now, you can observe glycoproteins. These glycoproteins are secreted into the outside surface of cell. That means onto the plasma membrane by the action of Golgi complex. By the action of Golgi complex. Here, the oligosaccharides contain the proteins that is present in the cell membrane which act as a receptor for the many immune cells. For example, you know very well glycoproteins. Glycoproteins is nothing but antibodies. Is it right? That antibodies are very essential for the recognition of the blood groupings. So, these antibodies nothing but glycoproteins also very important for the graft acceptance and graft rejection. Okay, this is all about the proteins and lipids, oligosaccharides. They forms the glycolipids and the glycoproteins. This is a very important function of the Golgi complex. The next point is this Golgi complex also secretes some enzymes. We know very well. But also, these secretes the hormones like thyroxine. Thyroxine hormone is secreted by the Golgi complex. Is it clear? The next important function of Golgi complex is vitellogenesis. Vitellogenesis is the process, the formation of yolk. The formation of yolk, which is called as a vitellogenesis. Actually, we know very well yolk is a nutrient material which is essential for the growth of the baby which is present in the mother's womb. You can just see here, for example, this is mother womb. The mother womb that contains embryo. In this way, actually embryo is present, like this. So, you can see the here is a two sac-like structure. One sac-like structure is called as yolk sac. In this yolk sac that contains the yolk. Actually, this yolk is secreted by the what? Golgi complex. Yolk is secreted by the Golgi complex, this yolk that contains the rich amount of the nutrients which are essential for the growth of the embryo. Another sac here is allantoin. We no need to discuss about the allantoin here. So, we have to understand yolk is secreted by the Golgi complex. Golgi complex. The next important point is the acrosomal action. Acrosomal action. Actually, acrosome is a part of the sperm cell. Acrosome is part of sperm cell. You can see acrosome is present here. This is the acrosome. This acrosome that contains the high number of the Golgi complexes. This acrosome contains Golgi complex secretes some enzymes. That enzyme which digests the outer layers of the egg. Then only fertilization will be occur. So, that is the main important function regarding to the Golgi complex which are present in the acrosome. Now, coming to the another function, formation of cell plate. Cell plate, especially cell plate which is formed in the cell during the cell division. Then, what is the cell division? The conversion of one cell into the two cells. The formation of one cell into the two cells. During the cell division, there are two cells are formed. For example, you just assume this is a plant cell. During the cell division, these plant cell that convert into the cell 1 and cell 2. Here, the cell 1 and cell 2 is formed by the formation of the cell plate in the equatorial place. For example, here are the place that is the equatorial middle place. This middle place actually that forms the a cell plate like structure. That cell plate is in the form of Golgi complex. These vesicles which are formed in the middle of the cell that divides the single cell into the cell 1 and cell 2. This is called as cell plate. So, in this way, the cell plate is formed by the Golgi complex. Now, the Golgi complex also very essential for the middle lamella formation. Middle lamella formation. Middle lamella formation can observed in the plant cell wall. Actually, we know very well the cell wall that is formed in the one cell and the cell wall that formed in the another cell which are very adjacent to each other. The cell one that produces the primary cell wall and also secondary cell wall and also primary cell wall. This cell also secondary cell wall and also primary cell wall.
In between them, there is a one layer that is called as a middle lamella.
Middle lamella.
This middle lamella divides these cells into two different individual cells. So, it acts as a cement-like structure and also it divides the two cells from each other.
Okay, this is all about the middle lamella. This middle lamella also formed by the Golgi complex.
So, these are the main important functions regarding to the Golgi complex, which are very essential for the cell survival and cell growth and also cell functioning. So, I hope it is very clear to understand.
So, you people understood this class very clearly. Please do subscribe my channel HSR BioInfo. Don't forget to like and comment. Thank you.